In this video, we are going to solve a problem which was asked in TCS CPA, which is basically conducted for the TCS Ninja candidate. This question is taken from the unique section. The unique section is generally of 15 marks, in which 10 marks is allocated to the coding part and 5 marks is of the MCQ question. So we are going to solve the unique coding part, which keeps the weightage of 10 out of 100. The question here we have taken is named as highest score. And the question is, student details are stored in a file in the following order with space as a delimiter: roll number, name, score. And we have to write a Unix command to find the name of the student who has the highest score. And the file will be given as a command line argument when the script containing your command will run. So we'll get three column: roll number, name and score, and we have to find the name of that student who has the highest score. So first of all, we'll create a input file which will contain this roll number, name, score column, and thereafter we'll go for the Unix command. We are going to use gEditor to write the Unix command and edit this input file. So let's copy paste these inputs and create a new file named as highestscore.txt. Now we'll create another file with an extension of .sh. Let's say highestscore.sh. And here we'll write the command line or the Unix command. Here in this case, we are going to use the awk programming language, which is almost similar to ACD and GREP. And since in this case we are having the three columns which is separated by space, so using the awk command will be very useful. And in any case, if you don't like this method, you can click on the I button and find the alternative method to solve this problem. So now we are inside our file highestscore.sh, and we are going to write or begin with the awk command. So the syntax is awk followed by single quotes, and everything should be written inside that single quotes. Since the column are separated by space in our input file, so we are going to pass empty quotes to the fs or the field separator, which is written inside the begin function. So begin all in capital letter followed by open bracket, and inside that fs, that is field separator, equals to double quotes, and inside that double quotes space, one space will be provided. Thereafter we are going to open the brackets of awk, that is curly braces. The commands written inside this bracket is run again and again until we reach at the last row of the input file. Here in this case, the last row is row number 6, which is 456 ERT, and score is 45. See, in this video we are going to use three things. The first one is FS or field separator that we have seen. The second one is NR or the number of record, and in simple word we can say that number of record or NR is nothing but the number of row. So if we check the input file, the first NR or the number of record is roll number, name, score, that is the row 1. The second NR or the second row is 2, 3, 4, ABC and 70. So this will continue up to the 6th NR or number of row equals to 6. And the third thing is $1, $2, $3. Here $1 represent the first column, $2 represent the second column, $3 represent the third column. So the first thing we are going to check is the number of record or the row number is greater than 1 or not. Since the first row is roll number, name and score, hence that is useless for us. So we'll start with the row number 2, which will give the actual data on which we need to work. So if NR is greater than 1, we are going to write our code here. And here we are going to take a variable which will be compared with the $3 or the score, and if that score is greater than maximum value or the variable we have taken, then we'll store the $3 and $2 in some new variable. So let's say we have taken a variable max, and if max is less than $3, then max equals to $3, and the other variable which we're going to store the name, let's say the variable is name, and the $2 which is assigned to the second column, that is name. Whenever we initialize a variable in the Unix, it automatically gets initialized to the zero value. So we don't need to write the zero value, max equals to zero or name equals to zero, separately. And now at the end, we'll pass the name of the input file, that is highest score.txt. And to print the name of a student who has scored maximum marks, we'll go at the end bracket and type print name followed by semicolon. So now we are done with the command. Now we'll run this code and check whether it is giving the correct output or not. And to run this SSH extension file, we'll go to the terminal. Our terminal can be opened using Ctrl+Alt+T. And to run the file, we'll have to simply type ./ and the name of that file, that is highest score.sh, and we'll simply press enter. Here you can see it is giving me the name as XYZ, and we'll check whether this has the maximum score or not by going to the highestscore.txt file. Yes, here you can see that the maximum score is 80, which is scored by the student that is named as XYZ. Hence, we are getting the correct output. You can try with your own sample cases. You will get the correct output by using this code. And in any case, if you haven't understand this solution or this technique, you can watch our other video, which will give you the different methods of solving the same question. Just press the I button and you will be there. So thank you for watching this video, and if you have enjoyed this video, please give us a like.